Professoressa Mast, quali sono le cause dell'obesità e quindi di questo fenomeno così dilagante che ha un impatto sociale così elevato?
Well, at the individual level, I think it is a result of energy imbalance, intake of too many calories relative to the amount expended. But I think that the choices are not at the individual level, and very often the obesity arises because of the environment in which people live. Most of my work is in children, and children are at the mercy of their parents in terms of what foods they eat, but they also ask their parents for the foods that they see advertised, and parents increasingly comply with those kinds of requests from their children. Children in the U.S. go to school and they may or may not be offered a healthy lunch. School feeding programs are imperfect and leave a lot of room for variability in terms of what is eaten. Some communities don't have good access to safe places for children to play after school or on the weekends, and also may not have access to healthy foods in food stores. It may be difficult to get good food at home. And then at the societal level, there are lots of regulations that influence what people are able to buy in stores, whether foods are advertised to children on television. So there are lots and lots of regulatory decisions that are made that impact on what the individual intake and physical activity levels are.
Per risolvere il problema, soprattutto affrontarlo rispetto al segmento dei bambini, quali sono gli interventi prioritari? È soprattutto una questione di educazione e quindi di comunicazione?
I think communication is important, but I think that communication alone is very unlikely to solve a problem of this magnitude and a problem that is so complex and has so many forces acting on it. So I think it's important that there's education, because I think as children grow up and become more aware, it's important that they have basic nutrition knowledge and basic knowledge of how to be healthy. But I think that the solutions to the problem are going to have to occur at the governmental and even international policy level for us to really turn around this this trend, because the economics of food and the way calories are moved around the world has, even though it seems hard to understand how that ends up influencing the individual child and what they eat at home, it actually has effects. It's just that they're not direct effects.
Secondo lei anche le grandi aziende hanno un ruolo e quindi una responsabilità nella soluzione del problema?
Yes, I definitely think that all corporations, big and small, all educational organizations, all governments have a role to play in this, because health is really a right. It's not a commodity that can be traded across the world.
La ringrazio, professoressa.
Thank you.